Video. Okay, so video number three. So this is going to be addressed to a lot of the brothers and sisters out there that are going through depression. Or is it anxiety? I can't remember what I was going to do. Let's do anxiety. So, yeah, first of all, I'll have to say, if you're new to this channel and you're new to any sort of these videos, I'll tell you right now, you are not alone. You are not alone. There are people out there who will help you. Who are out there who will help you if you're going through anxiety. Keeping it all in is the worst thing you can do. Even if it seems like really trivial, and even if it seems like, oh, you know, I shouldn't talk about it because maybe I'll feel bad, or, you know, maybe someone will think bad about me, or maybe someone will react negatively. Fuck it. Sorry. Screw it. Like, you know, don't get me wrong, there are times when there are times when if you tell your anxieties to someone, they're gonna, you know, be like, oh, okay. Like, for example, you're talking to your boss, but you have people out there that can really help you. You know, we're here for you. I'm here for you. This is why I'm making this bloody video, man. You're not alone. Also, this video is not so much, this part one is not so much about getting into the specific things, or I'm just gonna talk about the broad overview of anxiety and what to do if you feel like it, and some different random things. Also a bit of my own story. So I used to have tremendous anxiety. Huge anxiety, to the point where I would, let me move this over there, I remember the first time I actually went to a rave, technically, not really a party, and I was standing outside in the smoking area, pinned to the wall, like, please, no one talk to me, this is such a weird situation, you know, and you may be asking why was I there, but I'm glad I went there, because that rave changed my life, man, but that's another story, and I know what it feels, on a day-to-day basis to have that. I would describe it as like razor sharp claws, massive claws that would just like grab you around the midriff and just like whenever you wanted to actually, you know, interact, or whenever you wanted to, you know, do something that you know you need to do, and you just get this like, don't do it, and it would cause pain. And from that pain, you'd be like, oh, you know, this is bad, I should lock myself away and stuff. Or even worse, you'd be like me, whereby you'd be like, you know, you would develop some sort of a mental pattern whereby you'd be afraid of people seeing your anxiety, so you'd put on even more of a mask than you're already wearing, and then you'd just be weird all the time. You'd be weird all the time, and people would see it, but then you wouldn't acknowledge the fact that people could see it, because it was like, oh, I don't want to accept my own flaws and my own failures. And I actually got that from the transgenerational tendency of my parents and my grandparents, all the same. It's like, do not show your emotions. But my anxiety got so big that I was so afraid to show it, that I just found myself in this weird world where everything was, you wanted to try and put on this mask all the time, and stringent, but it was like I just was just pretending. I spent so much of my life pretending to be someone who I wasn't, basically, and you know. It sucked, and it got to the point where it just the kettle boiled over, and I thought, screw it. And I went through a whole thing whereby I started to reverse my anxiety through natural methods that I'll get into in a later video. But it basically ended up in me, you know, addressing my diet and taking loads of supplements and cleansing my system, so that the anxiety basically went away, you know. So I'd bet money that the vast majority of the anxiety that people experience is caused by physical imbalances, and yeah, you know, they have too much toxins, or they're not eating properly, their body doesn't have enough nutrients. Major thing, nutrients. If you're low on vitamin D, or if you're low on magnesium, if you're low in even sulfur, you can cause anxiety. You know, vitamin and mineral deficiencies are one of the main causes of anxiety. So yeah, I basically went through a whole process, but I tried to figure out what caused anxiety, and I found out the supplements to how to reverse it, to the point where now, like, take me two weeks, you know, gone, you know. But my other issue is that I had some self-sabotaging issues, which is why I'm trying to do the whole thing again. And if you check out my channel, I'm doing the juice fast. I'm basically restarting the whole reversing depression and reversing anxiety thing again. And I'll try and take you through it from like a day-to-day perspective, as someone who's doing a juice fast. And also try and shine a light in what the actual journey is like. But it's really amazing how there are so many people who have been living with anxiety for so long in their life. And they go to the doctors these days. And the doctors say, oh yeah, take this pill, take this antidepressant, take this antipsychotic. God. Oh, no. It's a pillow. It doesn't fix the issue. You're still sleeping on a bed of nails. They just give you a pillow. That's it. Like, they don't fix the issue. And then they tell you, like, oh, yeah, in 4 months, if you keep taking it, then, you know, everything's going to be fine. It's like, no, fix the issue. And the issue can be many, many things. And I'll try and get into each and every single one of those issues in the course of my videos. You know, if you go to a doctor, most days, they won't be able to fix your depression. Because even if you tell them, many of them will tell you, oh, you're just going to live with it and we can just dampen it. It's like, no, you can live anxiety-free. You can live depression-free. It's once you figure out how, it's like, oh, wow, I used to be suffering for the last 6 years of my life. And a month to 3 months later, everything is fine. It's gone. You know, so I really don't recommend going to psychiatrists to fix your anxiety and your depression. They may have some help. They may have be like, oh, yeah, you know, take this pill and go to... Or they may even recommend you to group therapy. And you're the kind of person who's like, you know, you're really socially anxious. And that group therapy will really break you out. You'll make progress. But you'll still be dealing with the day-to-day grind of anxiety. And it's like, well, how... You know, it's just like in some far-off future, you'll be free from this. But even though the doctor can't tell you when, he's just like, I take this pill and then when you're fixed, you're fixed. It's like... So yeah, I, as you can probably tell, I actually went through a lot of that. And I basically got to a point where it's like, these antidepressants don't work. I mean, in my darker days, I used to abuse a lot of substances. Don't do drugs, kids. Seriously, don't do it, you know, unless you're... No, just don't do it. Like, I basically got to a point where, like, you know, I'd take ecstasy, basically. I'd take E. And I remember taking E, because I took E for a while when I was was a lot younger than I am now. And I remember taking antidepressants, and it was like, it's the same thing. I remember looking myself in the mirror, like, wide-pupiled, like, I'm just rushing. I'm just on MZ. There's no difference. My issues aren't being solved. I'm just overly happy. But the situation hasn't changed. It's like getting into a car crash and taking a drug that makes you feel happy. It's like, I still had a car crash. This isn't helping me fix the car crash. I'm just really energetic for the wrong reasons, you know? So I really don't recommend going to a lot of doctors these days. I mean, don't get me wrong. I'm not a doctor myself. I've just been through the system, and I've talked to other people who've also been through the system. But, like, you know, if you really want to fix your anxiety, and we're just talking about anxiety now because depression is something different. I'll get into that in a later stage video. And I'll also answer questions about it. If you have a question about depression, ask it. I'll answer it as fast as I can. And I've lost my train of thought. So, yeah. Yeah, man, you're not alone. And anxiety is reversible. I've done it myself. As I said before, the key is the diet. If you have any unhealthy dietary tendencies, then that's one of the first things that you should do. Start, you know, eliminating and cutting out a lot of the excess sugars. Start taking some supplements. You know, even if it's a broad-spectrum multivitamin, start getting some exercise as well. Exercise just creates dopamine in your head. Literally, it's like, you want dopamine? Run, literally, just like just close this video and run if you want dopamine. It's right there. The answers are right there. The answers are right out there. And this is all I wanted to say for my introduction video. In the next video, I'll be talking about the different diet and just addressing the diet, not the supplements, just the diet and the importance of the diet and how your anxiety, more often than not, is influenced by what's going on in your body and what the stuff that you're putting into it. So, thanks for tuning in. Framing out, and peace.